Make That Central here. Thought we'd do something a little bit different. Take a look at a product and do somewhat of a product review. How about that? I got this cool thing in the mail from a guy I discovered online. It's the 1UPcard Give Your Game an Extra Life. It's a cleaning kit for the cartridges, for your cartridge-based games. So it's basically a retro gaming cartridge cleaning kit. Now you may be saying to yourself, I've got Q-tips. Why do I need this? I have Q-tips too. And I think this is a better solution. One of the problems with Q-tips is that they're fuzzy, and you get that fuzz all over the games. When you get into a cart, it just starts to snag on something in there, and you just wind up with strands of Q-tip fuzz all over the place. Plus, the stems on those things aren't that strong, and you can't really exert much pressure, and basically, they're much better for cleaning your ears. The 1UPcard, not good for cleaning your ears, but very good for cleaning your cartridges. So, you know, when I was a kid, actually, I wasn't a kid when I had an NES. I'm gonna say, when I was a kid and had an NES, but I was an adult when I had an NES, but that's just because I'm old. But anyway, I fell victim to that concept that, well, if all else fails, maybe blowing into the cart would actually do something. The problem is, oxidation is really what the culprit is in terms of putting in the cart and turning on the machine, and nothing happens. Now, I know with the NES, a lot of the problems with that ZIF slot, where you put it in and it sinks down and sort of the bend in that thing causing problems with the ribbon cable, but a lot of times with like your Atari, got some 7800 cartridges, 2600, and the 5200, is you put them in, and you still run that problem, and you put it in, you take it out, you put it in, take it out, and so forth and so on, until finally it would work. Well, really what you were doing was just sort of scraping the crud off the thing and getting a decent contact so that the game would boot up. But people who thought, you know, hey, maybe if I just blew into the game, that would do something. The problem is oxidation is caused by moisture. And when you're blowing, well, anyway, but when you blow into a game cartridge, you're basically introducing a lot more moisture to it, which is really not helping. Though the problem is if people take it out, blow on it, put it in, and blow on it again, they're just doing the same damn thing I used to do with the Atari cards. You put it in, take it out, put it in, and so forth and so on. But so we have a much better solution here. And the 1UP game card, or the 1UPcard, for your retro games, is basically a little bottle of 99% isopropyl alcohol. Excellent to use 99%. You don't want to have any water in it, because that's the moisture that's really not good for it. Now, it may seem simple to, you know, be cleaning off the contacts on video games with Q-tips, and it actually is, but the problem is, you go through an awful lot of Q-tips, and after seeing the 1UPcard, the Q-tips just don't do as good a job. You know, they're fuzzy, and you get the fuzz stuck to the contacts inside your game cart, which then can get inside your console. But this is a nice long surface. You know, you have this long surface that's going to rub against the contacts, and you put your isopropyl alcohol on that, and you pop it inside and just, you know, run it back and forth. And you want to do it on both sides so you get the front and back of the contacts. Then you have the dry side on which you have not put any alcohol. And you just pop it back in, you do the same thing, try and buff it off and dry it out. Now, I usually let a cart sit for, you know, a couple minutes before I shove it back in the console, simply to let anything evaporate because I don't want to introduce moisture into the console itself. But when it comes to looking at Q-tips versus the 1UPcard, I think this is a pretty clever product because it has a much wider surface and you can really get in and it's going to scrape them. Whereas with the Q-tip, you kind of run it back and forth, and I just don't feel it does as good a job, and it leaves a lot of fuzzy gunk behind. So that's not too cool. So I think this is a pretty neat thing. So we found the 1UPcard really cleans quite well for those carts when you shove them in your console and they don't want to produce a startup screen. You're just like, damn, I just wanted to play a game and you can't. Pop this in, scrub it back and forth, and this usually will get enough stuff off of there without the mess and all the problems with Q-tips and so forth. It's pretty cool. Give it a try and see if it doesn't help out with those cartridges that just plain don't want to work. Have a nice day. Keep it retro and clean your carts!